For the first time in human history, open source 3D printing has allowed people to create enormous wealth without necessarily having that much money. So 3D printer is just like a two-dimensional printer where it lays out in plastic design, it moves up a fraction of a millimeter and lays out that design again, and then continues to build it up until you have a three-dimensional object. And so people like GM and universities like Michigan Tech would have 3D printers, but only now has it become possible for everyday consumers to have a desktop three-dimensional printer like the one behind me. So a few years ago, for the first time in history, someone open-sourced the plans for a three-dimensional printer. And so because it was sort of building on that spirit of collaboration, the same way open-source software works, the prices for three-dimensional printers went from tens of thousands of dollars down to under $2,000. And so now you're able to both do rapid prototyping, but also manufacturing of household items, things to repair appliances, toys for your children, all in the comfort of your own home. And what makes this really interesting is that these are extremely high value-added products that are as easy to print as like a Word document. And so this brings the ability for people to manufacture high value, large creation of wealth for using a very small amount of money. And we've been using the three-dimensional printers at Michigan Tech to make scientific equipment. We've saved ourselves tens of thousands of dollars. And what we were interested in is, would this make sense for an everyday average middle-class American consumer? So we chose 20 objects that you could purchase online that people would have in their homes. Things like, this is a little carriage that you put on your bicycle to hold a water bottle, shower heads, things like this to juice a lime or a lemon, chess pieces, all different kinds of things. Things that you would normally have that you would normally buy at, say, your local Walmart. The number of open source 3D designs is exploding. It's expanding by exponential growth. There's more than 100,000 designs in a single database now. Everything that you would normally buy is now available, and you can customize it. So I have a PhD student that's working on printing electronic materials. And right now, we can do a cell phone case. In the near future, we might be able to do the cell phone case and an antenna. And in the not-so-distant future, you might be printing out entire electronic components in the comfort of your own home. At Michigan Tech, we've also developed a recycle bot, which allows you to take waste plastic or plastic parts that you are no longer happy with, throw them in a shredder, and then re-extrude 3D filament, which is sort of the ink for the 3D printers. And there's, maybe a dozen companies now that are developing some form of waste plastic extruder or recycling extruder. And so those are just hitting the market now. Most of them are in kind of Kickstarter status. But that will even further reduce the cost of using 3D printers.